Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 13.3.1 Beta 2 has been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, as this is my main phone, and I also have it installed on the iPhone 6S Plus, as well as some other devices. But in this video, I'm going to talk about how it's been for me over the past few days, then we'll talk about how it's been for you based off the YouTube community poll, and then I'll also read some of your comments at the end of this video. So check the description for the time codes if you just want to jump to a specific section. Now, the first thing is there's a new feature or a new button really that I haven't seen anyone mention that was found by one of my friends. And if you go into the TV app, and then maybe you go down to say watch now and you find something that you've actually watched before. So maybe the morning show, if you've watched that, you'll see that there's a button now that says play again. So this is actually new on 13.3.1 beta 2. It shouldn't be on previous versions. So you may see a button to play it, but you shouldn't see the play again button. So that's actually new. Another feature that my friend told me about that he actually found in the code is if we go into settings and then we go down to privacy, then under privacy, we go to location services, and then we go down to system services down at the bottom. Under system services, down towards the bottom, it says networking and wireless. This is the new feature that can disable networking and wireless location information, as well as wideband location information. So if we turn this off, you get a little pop-up that says turning off location for networking and wireless may affect Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and ultra wideband performance. So this is actually a new feature in there. If we take a look at a phone with iOS 13.3 on it, here's my 11 Pro Max or my 11 Pro versus the 11 Pro Max. If we go under privacy, then location services, system services, and at the bottom, you'll see there is no option for networking and wireless. So there isn't anything about that to turn it off for wideband or anything else. So it's on 13.3.1 beta 2. Now, as far as all of the other iOS 13.3 videos, if you want to see all of those, I've actually linked a playlist below. So if you want to see over 20 videos explaining different features or follow-ups and check back how things have been, I have those linked. I also have other playlists as well to all of the other previous versions of iOS that I've ever covered. So if you're interested to see how it was with iOS 12, if it was this buggy or anything, which it definitely was not, I have those linked as well. Now, the first thing is Echo is gone. I mentioned this in the iOS 13.3.1 beta 2 update video. And the Echo, when you're placing a phone call or a FaceTime call, isn't there anymore for the person on the other end. Now, there were a couple people that said it was still there. I recommended a hard reboot. I'm not sure if it fixed it, but for the majority of people, it's fixed in this beta. So if you had that issue, you should be good to go. Also, there are a few bugs for me personally. I've had good signal. I mentioned some of this before, problems switching from Wi-Fi to LTE, but today I had good signal and I tried to use my phone. It seems like there's a problem primarily in YouTube and YouTube Studio when I go to load a page. So sometimes it just wouldn't load. It would sit here like this, tell me I don't have a connection, and then it wouldn't work. After I used it for a little while, then it would work again. So the connection keeps cutting in and out. And people in Germany on O2, the carrier O2, are reporting issues as well with it. So it looks like it's not fixed, at least for me on T-Mobile. Maybe it is for you, but this is the first time I've seen it when it comes to actually just using the phone and then having it go away and come back. So I don't know what that's all about. It's when I'm on cellular, not Wi-Fi. The strange thing is my family that's also on T-Mobile is not having that issue on 13.3. So I've just started to see that cut in and out on this version for me. Let me know if you're having that issue though as well. Now, also the other issue I had was with messages. I didn't have an issue receiving messages on the phone, but when it gets sent to other devices. So for example, if you have a Mac or a MacBook or an iPad, you can relay the messages from your phone to that device and back. And you do that by going to settings and then messages. And then under messages here, you'll see text message forwarding. I have that set up for 5 devices, and you'll see that they're all set up. So my iMac Pro, the MacBook Pro, iPad, and a couple other phones, or the iPhone 11 and the Mac Pro. So I have these messages forward to them depending on which device I'm actually using. And in order for that to work, I actually had to turn this off and then back on. So I had to flip the switch off, turn it back on, and then it fixed the problem. So for whatever reason, I'm not sure why that happened, but for whatever reason it did, and now the messages work properly between the devices. And that's the only issues I've had with this. Performance has been good. I've had zero stutter, zero lockup. So if we go to settings and scroll, you'll see it's nice and smooth. And I am recording this video in 60 frames per second, as some of you requested to see smoothness and things. So hopefully that helps you see smoothness. If I scroll between pages, maybe there was a slight frame rate drop right there, but most of the time it's nice and fast. I've had no issues loading anything. Once everything's loaded, it scrolls nice and fast. So thankfully, for the most part, it's working well. So no issues there. And now, of course, a lot of you want to know about battery. Now, first, let me talk about battery health. So if I go into settings and then go to battery and then battery health, you'll see I'm at 100%. Now, a lot of you are saying, I wish they would make it so battery health goes up. And you can't do that. That's actually the health of the battery, the physical battery in your phone in the back. In order to increase battery health, you actually have to replace the battery. The update itself is not bringing that down. You actually have to get a new battery to bring that back up. It's just normal for lithium ion batteries to degrade over time. So let it degrade. I would ignore this number, just enjoy using it. And once it gets down to about 80%, then consider replacing it. Now, as far as battery for me, well, the past few days, I didn't use it a ton, I suppose, but you'll see today I've used it 1 hour and 33 minutes and then 1 hour and 5 minutes of screen off time. I haven't even used a quarter of my battery. So I've used 12% of my battery to get that. So battery life has actually been pretty good. You'll see if I go through these, it's pretty decent. I used over 25% yesterday and got 2 hours and 11 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 7 minutes of screen off time. So it's really doing well. 11 to 12 hours of screen on time. If you extrapolate this out, it should be no issues. Most of my usage is something like YouTube and Twitter and mail and things like that. So that's what's using my battery. Now, as far as what you had to say based off the YouTube comments, quite a few of you mentioned battery. Battery was mentioned 48 times, but on a positive note, a lot of you said it was much better battery. There's always a few that are going to say it's worse. And those few people said that the phone was heating up. So that means the processor in the phone is working hard. And when it's working harder, it's going to use more power. So there's something using your power. So again, go to settings, check what's under use here or what's using your battery, and look at your activity and see what's going on that's actually causing this to degrade and for your phone to actually heat up, because there's something running. And if it continues to happen, I suggest a hard reboot. So that's where you just force reboot the phone, and that usually fixes the problem. Other than that, one person said that mail was giving them an issue. I find that mail is no problem. You'll see it has one. It's there and it's working fine. It's much faster than it was before. So if we go into mail, you'll see I have one email and that's it. I'll just swipe it away. I leave my unread here and I'm good to go. It's nice and fast and I can read it fast and close it away or go back, swipe undo. It comes back. So it's nice and fast. No issues managing mail or anything like that for me. But some people or one person said they were having a problem still. Most people are saying it was resolved. And then a few other people, three other people mentioned LTE. Two out of the three said the LTE was better. So that's a good sign. Not many people complaining about LTE. So that means for most people, it's working well. Now, as far as the devices everyone is using, here's a list of all the devices based off the comments. If you didn't comment with a device, obviously I can't calculate this, but this is what people were talking about and which devices they were referring to the most. Now, as far as performance on older phones, expect the performance to be absolutely identical when it comes to older devices. So if I had good performance here, while this has a faster processor, expect that to be faster in most things. Overall, in general, performance on older phones was very good. So things like the iPhone 6S Plus, 7, 8, 10, 10R, any of those, people are not complaining about issues. The iPhone SE, they're saying that things are loading fast. So you'll see it's refreshing. There was a little stutter. It's refreshed and now we're good to go. So that's pretty typical of the way iOS refreshes things. It stutters a little bit until it's refreshed and then it's nice and fast. So you'll see here, it's loading for you. And again, it's going to stutter a little bit when it's loading that, but after that, it's super smooth. So again, if you're using that for things like weather or playing games or anything else, it should be the same or better than you had before. And the Geekbench scores from the previous video show that as well. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now on the YouTube community poll, 9.2K voted, so 9,200 people or so, or 9,200. So I really appreciate that. On betas, usually those numbers are pretty low, and that's really quite good for about 24 hours of time for time to vote and things like that. So I'll continue to see this go up and I'll be reading these in the future. But for this follow-up video, we have 104 comments and I've read every single one. And that's how I got the numbers I talked about earlier. Now, 14% of you said that this was great. Only 3% said it was terrible that we're running it. 5% said, okay, but some bugs. 62% of you are on iOS 13.3 or older public versions, and 16% of you are on Android. And I think people are right that are saying more and more people are just messaging or voting, I'm on Android. I think it was 15% last time. But either way, I appreciate your vote. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. Now let's sort this by the oldest first. Battery looks great, but for me, the Echo has still not gone when I use the speaker for communication. So again, I would recommend a hard reboot. I know a few people were having this issue, but it's pretty few and far between. Mine doesn't even show up. It says error searching for update. I did reinstall the profile, but it won't work. I've seen a few people say this. Make sure you're getting the profile from Apple and then reboot, and that usually fixes the issue. Great on iPhone 11 Pro, sorted the FaceTime Echo issue. Just two things I've noticed. The keyboard volume click issue is back. I also had one or two calls go to voicemail. I just got a missed call message. I rebooted my phone. Hopefully that helps. Make sure you don't have that option turned on for ignore unknown callers too. If you do have that option in settings, so if you go to settings and then you go down to phone, and at the bottom of phone, it says silence unknown callers. If that's turned on, it will automatically go to voicemail. So just keep that in mind. That's a nice feature, but you'll miss a lot of calls if you do that. Battery back on my SE is better on beta 2, but one issue bothers me a lot. Whenever I put an application in the background and open it after some time, the app freezes for like 5 to 6 seconds. Now, I didn't mention RAM management because not one person in the comments mentioned that. So I had somebody today on Twitter message me that said they had RAM management issues, but I haven't seen any issues whatsoever with that. Good battery and LTE connectivity is good. iPhone XS. I'm still getting the phone overheating and battery life seems to be shot. I usually never have issues like this either, but this little guy has messed me up pretty bad. And this is on the iPhone 11 Pro and iPhone 11 Pro Max. Thank God the speaker issue is fixed though. As far as the phone overheating, like I mentioned earlier, try and hard reboot your phone. Normally when the phone is warm, it's processing a lot of information. So there's something going on causing that drain. iPhone XS Max updated once it hit over the air. I have not experienced any issues that have at least noticeable, that have it or have been noticeable, I suppose. Great so far on my iPhone X, way better than beta 1. iPhone 11, 128 gigabytes, running great so far. No bugs that have affected my use. 13.3.1 beta 2 is working well on iPhone 7, though it wouldn't update until a day after the release. Still using 13.3 on the 11 Pro. It's good to hear the iPhone 7 is working well. I know some people had some weird issues with that one specifically. Great on 11 Pro Max and iPad Pro. Everything is smooth. Yesterday I had 4 hours and 40 minutes of screen on time and an hour of screen off time with 48% battery left too. My iPhone 7 seems to be running just fine at the moment. So far, so good. Switching to LTE bug is very annoying. I always have to refresh the network by airplane mode on and off. Same issue I have. Thankfully, it hasn't been as often with this beta, but it's still an issue for me. Everything seems to be good on the 11 Pro Max. My iPhone XS Max is heating up with this update. So I'll read a couple more. Does iPhone 7 get this update or not? This is a developer update, so it does get it, but you would need to be a developer or public beta tester. It will come to it later when it comes to the public. And then my iPhone XS Max is heating up with this update. And then again, I have an iPhone 11, but there's no update. You have to be a developer or public beta tester. So as far as when this should release to the public, I would expect within a week or two based off what we have now. So it's the 17th as I'm making this video, maybe next week or the week after, depending on when you're watching this. It's hard to say for sure, but then I would expect iOS 13.4 with some new features, and then major changes with iOS 14 in June, and then a final release of that in September. That's how the cycle works every time. Now, if you've stuck with me through this video, I really appreciate it. So I thought I'd ask you, if you've stuck with me this long, been thinking about making some videos about the next iPhone SE, the iPhone SE 2, for example, and some of the rumored iPad changes. Let me know if you'd like to see a video about that in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.